think I'm going to be on very long. Just trying out my new splash screen. A new intro screen. So I gotta figure out the fades and everything. Yo, what is good? What is good? All right. So where was I last night? Yeah, I ain't gonna be on too long. Maybe like a half hour or something. Kind of get everything situated here. So let's see here. I don't think I'm gonna mess with the hair. Maybe I'll get into blocking, start blocking out some of the background elements. What happened to my hotkeys? Uh-oh. Where are my hotkeys? They don't seem to be working. Not good. Should be the right hotkeys. Ooh. Nope, it's doing some other thing there. What is going on with my hotkeys? They deleted somehow. Oh, shoot. I forget how to do that. Oh, my hotkeys broke. Anyway. That works. Oh no. All right, let's just, I forget how to assign hotkeys. Let me look this up real quick. Control plus all. All right. So I had the modeling on control plus alt. There we go. Then we had brush. All right. No, not that brush. My brushes. use this piece. Let me go ahead and get a cube. Those cubes. There we go, that's what I want, the quad cube. Not the crazy looking cube. Off when you control shift control, you can go ahead and duplicate a piece. So I can see what's going on. I guess that's pretty good. Get our Z modeler tools and go ahead and bridge these two, these ends here. Go to bridge and go to two holes. That should do the trick. Stitch to endpoint. I guess we can get all these. Oh, what the hell happened here? See what happened. Kind of got a damage. Deal with that getting wonky on me, and I can just pull that out. Can just go ahead and extrude this again. Maybe we'll get a nice little bevel on the edge there. Thing with control W, yeah, that's how you can assign and polygroup something. You will go polygroup, slide, edge loop complete. Give it a nice rounded look. Bevel these edges. Right here. Okay, why are you doing this? Why are you doing this? What in the world? What the hell is going on here? Go ahead and delete that and rebridge it. I don't know. Looks like it created some weird piece in there. All right. There we go. There. Like new. Now I don't know why. I don't know why that's... Oh, okay, poly loop, that's why. Alright, I must have accidentally selected that. So, yeah, to do, you want edge loop complete for that bevel. There. And we kind of got all that situated. Alright. See how that looks with dynamic subdivs. Get a couple support loops in there. There we go. looking pretty good. So I could get a floor in here too. Dun, 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 dun. That's looking all right. So I guess I could create the supports pieces of a bridge. Start to create that off. And we just have, let me think about this for a second. Bam, 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 bam. Some edge loops. Probably don't even need to use radial symmetry on this. Oops. We just want single edge loops. Go ahead and do a shift extrude. Get something like that. I know it's kind of fat right now. Mm-hmm. should be a little thicker. Want this a little more rounder. Oops. Cool thing, one of the things I really like about Z modeler tools is the memory of your last action. So if I scale that, all I gotta do is tap that and all you gotta do is tap the next one and it's going to move that proportionally. To the original, to the first action. So it's kind of like a, it's kind of like a auto history kind of thing, but it's very cool. These. This I will do crease by poly groups. Let's see what we got. Yeah. Let's Whoa, why are we? There we go. Oops. These ones on the corner can be a little heftier, but let's not do that yet. Just gonna see, do a test run here. have to take a break.
My freaking shoulder
starting to ache a little, so I'm gonna take 5. I will be right back. Check out my new BRB. All right, and we are back. Losing my keyboard here. All right. BRB. There we go. And so the next thing I want to get is this little lantern. These lanterns on the post is going to be a light source. So let's go ahead and block that out real quick. And that'll probably be it for tonight. So let's see what we can do. Let's see if I can repurpose this. So I don't know what I could do. I can just go ahead and extract this top. We control extrude and just start off with what do we do here? Go ahead and auto group that. There we go. Go ahead and split hidden. And then we got this piece right here by itself. And I can go ahead and extrude that right away for the base. And scale that. Such, and I guess I can move this into position because looks like I almost want to say this is like a bowl shape through here, but I'm not sure. Concave in there. We could try that. Oops. I don't want to do that. just go with that. Why is this? Oops. Looks like it's got like a little kind of like a bowl shape. Oops, I don't want that. So. weapon. It looks like it's got like a roof on this part. Is different here. What is not? All right, this. have to go. There we go. Seek out some reference and the next stream, but I can go ahead and get everything, all the elements that are supposed to be here. And so the next thing we have is this little, looks like it has a little bulb at the top. Oops, we don't want that. Much thinner. And we will get our little bulb here. Down. There we go. And for the most part, I do want to get these I'll probably finish those this up tomorrow, but I just want to see. Probably use radio symmetry for this, but I think we'll be all right. Huh. So it's kind of uneven. so 3 is gonna work. Figure out how to make those round. Port loop in there. Oops. Should be good. Did we get them? Yeah, we got support loops there. There we have it. And that'll conclude this for tonight. I really appreciate you watching. And good night. Or should I say good morning?